In Arizona, two small planes collided mid-air, killing two people. It's the latest in a series of plane crashes and crash landings that have made headlines in just the last month, and many now left with concerns about how safe is it to fly. WLWT News 5's Rachel Hirschheimer is live near CVG with those concerns, Rachel.
Ashley, if you have a flight coming up in the next couple of days and you're a little nervous or anxious about it, know that you are not alone. But an aviation expert tells us you actually have nothing to worry about. When catching a flight, safety is top of mind.
I'm not too worried about it. I'll still fly for work, so I'm continuing to fly no matter what.
In recent weeks, there's been multiple plane crashes making national news.
I think it's fine. I know there have been lots of major headlines lately about plane issues, but cars crash every day too, and we still drive, so I think it's okay.
In January, 67 people were killed in a mid-air collision in Washington, D.C. Earlier this month, a medical jet crashed in a Philadelphia neighborhood, killing six people on board and one person on the ground. This week, a plane crash landed onto its roof in Toronto. Everyone survived.
Again, I can't overemphasize, we're still incredibly safe.
Pilot Josh Hunter says despite recent turbulence, these incidents are rare.
Anybody actually looks at the numbers, they'll realize that flying is still literally orders of magnitude safer.
According to the National Transportation Safety Board, in January last year, there were 80 plane crashes in the U.S. January 2025, there were 63 crashes. The numbers are extremely low in the tri-state. This past January in Ohio, there was one plane crash and none last year.
We spend years as pilots training and getting better even after initial certification. So that level of safety just cannot be matched compared to driving, despite all the news.
So Josh Hunter says if you are still really nervous about flying despite all of those statistics, he recommends hopping on a flight and see how it is for yourself. Reporting live tonight, Rachel Hirschheimer, WLWT News 5.